Hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. Today we are going to discuss one more important topic of cell, that is plastids. Okay, plastids. These are the very important components of plants and some other photosynthetically active animals. So basically these plastids more abundantly present in the plants. Okay, these plastids are very essential for the preparation of food. The second point is the storage of food. And coloration of plant products. So let us see how these plastids that involved in the preparation of food, which means the plastids that are involved in the photosynthesis and which results the preparation of food. Whereas after preparation of food, these plastids that store the prepared food in the form of tubers and etc. Okay, let us see coloration of plant products. We know very well plant products like fruits and flowers. These fruits and flowers are showing the different colorations. One fruit to the another fruit, they are showing the different colors. Some fruits showing the blue color, some fruits showing the green color, red color, orange color, like that. Similarly, the flowers also showing the many colors. So, all these colors are due to the presence of plastids. Let us start with the how many types of plastids which are present in the plant kingdom. Okay, now actually these plastids broadly divide into two categories. One is leucoplast, second one is the chromoplast. Here the leuco and chromo, these are two important words to be remembered. The leuco means colorless, whereas chromo means color. Here that means the plastid that contains the color, such all plastids comes under the chromoplasts. The plastid that doesn't contain the color, such all plastids comes under the leucoplast. Let us start with the leucoplast. So, leucoplast are the plastids which are present in the plant products or plant organs. All these plant organs, those doesn't expose it to the light. If the plastids that doesn't expose to the light, such plastids we called as a leucoplast. If the plastid that exposed to light that converted into the color forms, such plastids we called as a chromoplast. So the chromoplast which exposed to light. Okay, so again these leucoplasts that are present beneath the earth or in the soil. Okay, the plant components or plant organs which are present beneath the earth or within the soil, such organs that contains the leucoplast. Here the plant organs or plant parts that are present outside of earth, such plant products or plant parts that are exposing to the light, such products we called as a chromoplast. Such plant parts that contain the chromoplast, so which are present above earth. Actually see, these leucoplasts that are essential for the storage of food. which all the plant components that stores the food. Here, these are the very essential for the coloration of plants. Coloration of plant parts and products. So, in this way, the differences between the leucoplast and chromoplast are present. Again, one more point to be noted, the leucoplast are the plastids. These plastids that doesn't contain the a component of plastids that is called as the grana thylakoid. We will see what is the grana thylakoid. Actually, these are the grana thylakoids are very essential for the pigmentation. If the plastids that contains the grana thylakoid, such grana thylakoid that stores the different colors. So, pigments are nothing but colors. Such type of grana thylakoids are absent in the leucoplast, whereas such grana thylakoids are present in the chromoplast. Okay, these are the main important differences between the leucoplast and chloroplast. Now, the leucoplast again divided into three important categories, which includes one thing is the proteoplast or aluranoplast. The second one is a amyloplast. The third one is the ileoplast. So, these three are the different kinds of leucoplast. Here, how this classification is done, that means based on the food item in the form of biomolecule that stored in the plastids, these leucoplast again divided into three types. Let us see proteoplast that stores the proteins. Proteoplast store the proteins, so which is called as a proteoplast. And also it is also called as a aluranoplast. Again, see amyloplast that store the carbohydrates. If the leucoplast that storing the carbohydrates, such leucoplast we call as the amyloplast simply. Again, here we can see ileoplast that stores the oils or lipids. So, the lipid storing leucoplast we call as the ileoplast. The example for this proteoplast that storing the proteins, these all are the cereals. The cereals that is most abundant in the proteins. The cereals actually that are the leucoplast. Here amyloplast that is the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are rich in the tubers like potato tuber. Such tubers that are most abundant in the amyloplast, that amyloplast storing the carbohydrates. Coming to the ileoplast, oils. Oils are lipids. We know very well oils are lipids that are coming from the plant products like groundnut oil. Okay, groundnuts and also some sunflowers. So, this type of seeds actually that contains the ileoplast that storing the lipids. These ileoplasts are the colorless, such way it is called as a leucoplast. Okay, it is clear. Now, coming to the chromoplast. Let us see the chromoplast. Chromoplast again divided into three important categories. One is a chloroplast. Second one is a pheoplast. The third one is a rhodoplast. chloroplast, pyroplast and rhodoplast. These are the plastids. These are the plastids. Actually, these plastids that contains the grana thylakoid. That contains the grana thylakoid. So, the chloroplast that contains the grana thylakoid we called as a chlorophyll. Actually, grana thylakoid are very essential for the storage of some pigments and containing some pigments. Such pigments are attached by the some components of these plastids we called as a chlorophyll here. Here, pyroplast that contains the grana thylakoid, such grana thylakoid we called as a xanthophyll. Xanthophyll. Rhodoplast that contains the phycoerythrin. Now, let us see. These are the thylakoid components. Now, these thylakoid components that storing the different colors, different pigments. For example, see the chlorophyll that storing a color we called as a green color. Now, xanthophylls that storing a color we called as brown color. Brown color. The phycoerythrin that stores the red color. Red color. So, this is all about the chromoplast. Now, the examples for the chloroplast that contains the chlorophyll which storing the green color is all plants. All especially plant leaves. The green plant leaves, those comes under the this class. Now, coming to the xanthophylls. The xanthophylls actually comes under the brown algae. Brown algae that contains the xanthophylls, especially pyroplast. Coming to the phycoerythrin that are present in the red algae. Red algae. So, these are the examples for the each class about chromoplast. Now, let us see along with these plastids, along with these chromoplast, there are some pigments that are stored in the different plant products. For example, carotenoids. This is the color. This is color which is present in the carrots. Okay. Lycopene actually which is present in a tomatoes. The third one is a capsanthin. This is present in the red peppers. So, these are the colors like this. Phycoerythrin, xanthophylls, chlorophylls. These are the carotenoids and lycopene, capsanthin. These are the storaging forms that store in the red color. Carotenoids coming, looking like a orange color or red color. Here also lycopene that is present in the tomatoes. This lycopene stores the color like red or orange. Here also capsanthin that is stored the red color in the red peppers. These all are the different types of colors and different types of thylakoids which are present in the different plant products. Okay, it is clear. Now, the important point to be here noted, the leucoplast, if the leucoplast that exposed to the light, such leucoplast that converted into the chromoplast. Is it right? Now, the chromoplast which are induced to the dark condition, such chromoplast that converted into the leucoplast. This is the interchanging mechanism here. These are changing like this and these are changing like this. If leucoplast that exposed to light,
such leucoplast convert into the chromoplast.
If chromoplast that exposed to dark, such chromoplast that converted into the leucoplast. Is it right? So in this way, the plastid classification is occurred, and also different kinds of plastids storing energy moieties and also plastids showing the pigments. Okay, is it clear? So in this way, this is all regarding to the classification of plastids which are present in the many plants and also many plant products. Is it right? No, I hope it is a very clear to understand. If you really like this video, please do subscribe my channel HSR Bioinfo. Don't forget to comment and like. Thank you.